गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतानः शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुःसाक्षात्परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम डियर फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग द 13th अध्याय ऑफ गीता। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी कंप्लीटेड द लास्ट मंत्र ऑफ द लास्ट श्लोक ऑफ द 12th चैप्टर, दैट इज भक्ति योग, एंड वी ऑल्सो हैड ए ब्रीफ रिव्यू ऑफ द होल से 12th चैप्टर, एंड देन नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट द 13th अध्याय। सो वी हैव बीन नाउ एंड देन टॉकिंग अबाउट द ओवरऑल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द गीता। So if you recall, I was just telling about the overall structure of the Gita. There are 18 chapters in the Gita, and these 18 chapters, they fall into a pattern, because all this is a message which is given by a very very expert teacher like Lord Krishna. So when an expert teacher, and that too Bhagavan himself, gives a message, automatically, unconsciously, there is some pattern in that, isn't it? And the subject matter is, what is Jiva and what is Jagat, what is the ultimate reality. So that is the subject matter. So this has been told in the Upanishads in various Mahavakyas, Tattvamasi, Aham Brahmasmi, Ayam Atma Brahma, etc., etc. Some Mahavakyas have been told. So here, when Lord Krishna has started describing, telling about this Brahma Vidya to Arjuna, when Arjuna was standing in some sort of confusion about his own duty, Krishna gave a broader picture of what is dharma, what exactly is the role of jiva, what is the nature of jiva. So all these things he told, and then gave a totally broad picture about what is dharma and what Arjuna has to do. And in that process, he told about several things. He gave a broad picture, and also he also showed Arjuna the limited picture. This is where you fit in. Because any teacher, he has to tell as to where the student fits in also. So he also very clearly told, you fit in at this slot called Karma Yoga. So he fixed him there. But still, you have to know what is the ultimate. So that is why he told about the nature of Brahma, that is the supreme reality. And then he told about some sadhanas, etc., etc. And in those sadhanas we have seen, and we have been talking about the structure of this Gita, that is, it is divided into three sections. The first six chapters, the next 7th to 12th is one group, and 13th to 18th is one group. So you take this Mahavakya. Mahavakya, one Mahavakya, that is Tat Tvam Asi. Let us take this Vakya, not the other Vakyas. So there, Tat is that supreme reality. Tvam is about the Jiva, who you are, what is your what is your nature, your essential swarupa, what are your constituents. So that is your nature. Then asi, then how exactly are you that? So it has also to explain how you are that. Simply by saying that you are that, the man does not, or simply by doing some dhyanam or meditation, I am that, I don't become that, unless I do it in a proper way, unless I do a proper viveka as contemplated in Shastra. Viveka, that is vichir, prathak bhave, that is you have to distinguish, prathak bhava, that is vichir prathak bhave, it is from that root. So that is, you have to do some viveka, you have to distinguish atma from anatma. You have to do the all such as like removing the chaff from the grain. You have to do all that viveka. So when you do that only, it will come. You will realize that you are not your what you think you are, but you are something else. So that equation also has to be told, asi. So tat, tvam and asi, these three points, these three things constitute one full sentence, isn't it? So these three words are explained in these three portions of the three parts of the Gita. That is what we discussed earlier. एंड द फर्स्ट सिक्स चैप्टर्स दे टॉक अबाउट नॉट तत् दो द महावाक्य फर्स्ट सेंटेंस इज फर्स्ट वर्ड इज तत् द फर्स्ट सिक्स चैप्टर्स ऑफ द गीता दे टॉक अबाउट त्वम दट त्वम पदार्थ विवेचनम सो दट इज वाट वी रेड सो वाट इज जीव what are all the activities he does, karma, dhyana, yoga and all these things we talked about. So the whole nature of jiva, predominantly let us say, predominantly all those things were discussed. Though of course Sankhya Yoga gives an overall picture of the Gita. So it gives an overall picture of the Gita. All the whole argument which is there in the Gita, it is briefly contained there. And similarly in the 18th chapter it does a summary of the whole Gita. So leaving these two, but predominantly this first six chapters they talk about the Tvam Padartha. Then the next six chapters, that is 7th to 12th, which we have completed in the last class, they talk about this Tat Padartha, that is the nature of reality. So there the reality at two levels we talked about, the higher degree of reality and the lower degree of reality, what was called para prakriti and what was called apara prakriti. So those things we discussed, and we also talked about what is called nirguna brahma, and we talked about saguna brahma, and we discussed various channels, that upasana etc. So that is why this upasana shatkam dvitiyam sampurnam, my book says at the end of the 12th chapter this book has given a last word, that ityupasana shatkam dvitiyam sampurnam. So that upasana shatkam is over. So now we are starting this next group of six. In this next group of six, this equation tat tvam asi, how you are that, has to be explained. And if you want to become that, what you have to do, that also has to be told. Where you are and what you have to do to reach a higher level, that has to be told. So that is the purpose of this Tritiya Shatkam. So this is one point. Then this is about this last, what is the strategy of this Shatkam. So the methodology is to explain again the Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasana, what in what manner you have to do Nididhyasana, what exactly you are and how you have to do Nididhyasana. For this, Anandagiri uses a word, Antima Shatke Vakyartha Nishtaha, Samyagdhi Pradhanaha Adhuna Arabhyate, Samyagdhi Pradhanaha. So here you are taught about Nididhyasana, what exactly, in what manner you have to meditate, in what manner. Now meditation not in the sense of meditating on some mantra or something like that, reciting some name, Om Namah Shivaya, not like that. It is meditation in a proper way, in a Shastra, how Shastra prescribes. So that sort of meditation or that sort of Nididhyasana is the emphasis here. So it is to ensure that you elevate yourself from that jiva level to that Ishvara level. So this is what we see, and so in this chapter the entire chapter deals with that only. It tells about what we saw as para prakriti and apara prakriti. We see in different names here. So the whole adhyaya it deals with this kshetra and kshetrajna. Then the 14th adhyaya, if you go to 14th adhyaya again, it talks about the gunatraya vibhaga yoga. There again, what is that gunatraya? Gunatraya is apara prakriti only. Again that apara prakriti is explained, how you have to overcome that gunatraya. So that strategy is told. Then if you come to 15th adhyaya, it is called purushottama prapti yoga. So in that purushottama prapti yoga again, it talks about how you have to develop vairagya. The very first shloka, it is somewhat like the shloka which we read in Kathopanishad. We read that shloka about that inverted tree, the tree where the roots are upwards and the branches and all these things are downwards. Urdhvamulo avakshakaha yeshoshvatha sanatanaha, we read there. So here again we read a very very similar shloka. Urdhvamulam avadashakam ashvattham prahur avyayam chandamsi yasya parnani yastam veda saveda vit. So that sort of, it starts like that in order to generate vairagya towards this samsara. So that 16th, 15th adhyaya, it moves like that. Then 16th adhyaya, it again talks about what is this Gunatraya Vibhaga Yoga. Daivasura Sampad Vibhaga Yoga. What is this Daivi Sampad and what is Asuri Sampad? What sort of characteristics you have to have in order to move upwards? And Asuri Sampad, that demonic acquisitions, not necessarily wealth. Sampad does not necessarily wealth, not necessarily mean wealth, but various other things, various other characteristics, various other personality traits. So all these things are Sampad only. If you are a virtuous man, that virtuous nature again is a Sampad. So that is a Daivi Sampad. So some other sinful nature, that is the Asuri Sampad. So Sampad does not necessarily mean something in terms of cash and money. So this Daiva, what is Daivi Sampad and what is Asuri Sampad? And what sort of characteristics a seeker should have in order to promote himself to a higher status? So that is told in the 16th chapter. Again in the 17th chapter, it talks about Shraddha. Faith, not exactly faith, Shraddha not necessarily means faith. It is a question of trust, commitment and devotion all put together. Trust, commitment and devotion all put together becomes Shraddha. It is not some blind faith in something. So Shraddha Traya, this three types of Shraddha. So Sattvika Shraddha, Rajasa Shraddha and Tamasa Shraddha, they are talked about in that. Then again, 18th chapter again, it summarizes the whole text of Gita. So that is how this the last six chapters are structured, starting from 13th chapter to 18th chapter. That is how these things are structured, and we will now get into this. We will now see what exactly is the subject matter of this 13th chapter. So this 13th chapter starts with that viveka or discrimination about what is atma and what is anatma. So the chapter, if we just want to have an overview of this chapter, the name as we see is Kshetra Kshetrajna Yoga. Kshetra, Kshetra means a field. Kshetrajna, one who knows the field, one who understands the field, one who realizes what it is, one who realizes what its real nature is. So that man is the Kshetrajna. So when we just listen to the word Kshetra, you immediately you get a picture of some field, isn't it? Kshetra, the very metaphor means you imagine a field, and then in that field you try to sow some seeds. If you want to put mango tree, it will give a mango fruit. You want to put some neem tree, it will give a neem seed. Or if you want to put some poisonous seed, it will give a poisonous fruit. So whatever you put there, it will yield that type of harvest. So that is what is the peculiarity or nature of a kshetram. So the kshetram is something that is figurative of something which will give a result according to your action. So that is what is kshetram. So then the kshetrajna, who is the kshetrajna? Somebody who is understanding this. So that means kshetram is something which is, when you say something is a kshetram or a field, it means that it is not you, isn't it? Kshetram is certainly not you. Kshetram is yours. You are somebody who is an observer of that. So this human body is so peculiar that chaitanyam is very much part of it. Chaitanyam is very much there because it is chaitanya abhasa, which is actually enabling this whole body mind complex to function. Otherwise the body cannot function on its own, the mind cannot function on its own, the prana shakti cannot function on its own unless this chaitanyam is there. But then this chaitanya or consciousness is so mixed up, so intricately mixed up with this body mind complex that it sees itself as the body mind complex. The Chaitanya, instead of realizing its real nature as Chaitanyam, it is so mixed up with this body-mind complex that it thinks itself as the mind, thinks itself as the Antahkarana, and all these Antahkarana dharmas, the characteristics of the Antahkarana, like happiness, unhappiness, Sukha, Dukha, Hrir, Dhir, Bhi, all these characteristics, it thinks, oh, these are all mine. So it unfortunately confuses about its own identity. And the reason is that adhyasa, ignorance, that paras itaretara adhyasa, that is due to ignorance. And that ignorance, how to come out of that ignorance, so that is the matter here. So kshetrajna is somebody who can distance himself, who can know that this body, when I say that idam, we saw this word idam in whatever, Keno Upanishad also. Neidam yadidam upasate, that is in the context of Brahman. In the context of Brahman, not this which can be conceptualized, not this which can be objectified. Whatever is objectified is martyam, alpam. Whatever is idam, that is martyam, that is alpam, that is what Shankaracharya said there. So something similar has to be applied here. The same thing can be applied here also. Whatever is idam is something which is an object, which is something which is not you. It is not your real nature. So that is how this is a big exercise of nididhyasana. This whole thing is a very big exercise in nididhyasana. Unless you do this anusandhana, brahma anusandhana, you have to do this shastra adhyayana in a proper way, shravana, manana, etc. It has to be done in a proper way. And then that nididhyasana has to be continuously done. Only then a person will be, and also coupled with that, you should also have a pure mind. All these things are prerequisites. Merely this shravana manana nididhyasana will not give. A person in whose mind there are still a vast amount of raga dvesha, a vast amount of prejudices, vast amount of vasanas, when all these things are there, you just cannot do any nididhyasana. If your mind is still thinking about your, if my mind is still thinking about what I did some 10 years ago, all my achievements or failures, whatever it is, all those things, if I am thinking about them, I will not be able to do any nididhyasana. So I have to get out of that. I have to forget all those vasanas. I have to erase all those vasanas and then do nididhyasana if I have to understand what is my real nature. So that applies to anybody. A seeker has to give up all these vasanas. Then he has to do this shravana manana nididhyasana. And in that nididhyasana only, he will be able to distance himself from this body-mind complex. So, somebody who can distinguish himself or separate himself from that, he is called kshetrajna. So, who is this kshetrajna? What is the real nature of this kshetrajna if you see? Then, here of course, I took the help of one very good book. In the last class also, I brought that book, I showed it to you. That is Gita Shastrartha Viveka by Sachidanandendra Saraswati. I told about one Swamiji from Karnataka, renowned Swamiji, who has written with great clarity this Gita Shastrartha Viveka. So he says, who is this Kshetrajna? He has a discussion, there is a brief discussion about what is Kshetrajna and what is Kshetra, etc. So Kshetrajna is in this Vyavahara Dasha. Vyavahara Dasha, he is this Antahkarana Avachinna Chaitanya. One who is Antahkarana, having Antahkarana, not only Avachinna, but Antahkarana Tadatmya. One who has identified himself with this Antahkarana. So the Jiva who is associated with that ignorance, he is at the Vyavaharika level. But Paramarthika level, at Paramartha Dasha or Paramarthika level, he is the Brahman itself. So this Kshetrajna is Jiva at a Vyavaharika level. And Kshetrajna is Brahma at the Paramartha level. So this is the one fundamental thing which we have to note. Otherwise, you will be confused. What is Kshetra and what is Kshetrajna? We will have to get back to that old story of Ramayana. A person heard the whole Ramayana and at the end he had a doubt. What is Rama to what is Rama's relationship with Sita? So after listening to the whole Kshetra Dhyaya, we should not have any doubt. So you may note down. Kshetra is something which is objectified. Kshetram, the very word idam shariram, when we say idam, whatever you designate as this or it is something which is objectified. Then Kshetrajna is somebody who is able to distance himself, who is able to pull himself out of that body-mind complex and sees himself as that Chaitanya Swarupa. So Kshetrajna at the Vyavahara Dasha is a Jiva who is identifying himself with that Antahkarana Tadatmyam, Antahkarana. And then at the Paramartha Dasha, he is the Brahman itself, he is the pure consciousness. So that is what we will see here in this chapter. Then If you see the just overall overview of this chapter, there are 34 verses here, 34 shlokas, so it is not a very big chapter. But then of course, for the second shloka, Shankaracharya has written probably the longest possible bhashyam. So he has discussed several, he has raised and discussed several questions there. So of course that we will go through. We require a lot of patience to read that. We will go through that. So in this chapter, there are these 34 verses can be divided into 5 groups. For example, shloka 1 to 6, they give an explanation of what is kshetram and what is kshetrajna, what is the meaning. Kshetram does not mean only the human body. You see, the human body is made of what? The human body again is a karyam. And what is the karanam? Karanam is that prakriti. Prakriti is starting with that avyakta. So right from that avyakta and then that vyakta prakriti and then this trigunatmika prakriti and then all that pancha mahabhutas and then this pancha tanmatras and then mahabhutas and then this antakarana, buddhi, etc., etc., which have all derived from there. And then all our five senses, the five senses are derived from this five pancha tanmatras, the sattvika aspect of the five elements, isn't it? You remember, I hope you remember all that. And then the mind is derived from the collective sattvikamsha of all the five bhutas. So all this we remember. So when we say kshetram, it is not only the human body which is the kshetram. Of course, the very first shloka says idam shariram kaunteya kshetram. The very first shloka of this chapter is going to say this human body is a kshetram. It is emphasized, it is only for the sake of emphasis it is told, for the sake of emphasis, because first of all you have to understand that this body is not you. So in order to see that you understand this, the first thing to be understood in order to have vairagya, you have to understand the real nature of a thing, isn't it? So that is why for emphasis sake it is told like this. But really speaking, kshetram includes all other things, that is mahabhutani, ahankara, buddhi, avyakta, all those things. They all belong to this thing called kshetram. Why? Because all those things can be objectified. All those things, they are all pramana gochara, except avyakta. Avyakta of course is not pramana gocharam. But all the right from this level of trigunatmika, they are all known. They are all vyakta. So that is why all these things which can be objectified, they are all kshetram. Body is not different from macrocosm. This microcosm is not different from macrocosm. So when you call this as a kshetram, that also becomes a kshetram. So that we have to remember. Kshetram does not mean body alone. It means the whole prakriti. So that also you can note down. So this chapter, this verses 1 to 6, they explain what exactly is this kshetram. What is kshetrajna, etc. Then the 7th to 11, they talk about what is jnanam. What is jnanam? Jnana sadhana upakaranani. That is, what are all these characteristics, what are for realizing this jnanam. Then shlokas 12 to 18, they talk about the jnaya. They talk about this Brahma. What is this supreme jnayam? Jnayam means something which has to be known, something which has to be realized, understood. Not an object. Jnayam can give two meanings. Depending on the context, jnaya also means an object. This pen becomes a jnayam for my jnanam. So, but here of course, here when I talk about jnaya, we are talking about that supreme reality which has to be realized. So, verses 12 to 18, they talk about that thing to be realized. Then 19 to 22, they again talk about prakriti and purusha. Prakriti and Purusha are again two words for the same Kshetra and Kshetrajna. So here we are seeing different terms in this Adhyaya. For example, these words Kshetra and Kshetrajna, probably we are listening for the first time. We have not come across these words earlier, either in the Bhashyam, maybe in the Bhashyam they may be there, but in the text, these words Kshetram and Kshetrajna have not come, isn't it? So kshetram is something which is an objectifiable thing, and kshetrajna is somebody who is of the nature of intelligence. So similarly, this prakriti and purusha which are talked about in verses 19 to 22, Prakriti is something which is objectified. Purusha is something which is the knower or Kshetrajna or the intelligence principle. So that is how it is. Then the last verses, that is starting from 23 to 34, they talk about this sadhana, nididhyasanam, jnana nishta. So that is how the paragraph is structured. And at the end of this chapter, if we closely examine these words which are used, Kshetram is the same as Prakriti. You can note down, Kshetram is equal to Prakriti. You can note down, Kshetram is equal to Prakriti. It is equal to Apara. Apara, we know, Apara Prakriti, Para Prakriti, which we saw in 7th chapter. And it is also called Drushyam. It is equals Vishaya. Vishaya means an object. And equals Anatma. Equals Jadam. So all these things you can note down. Kshetram is equal to Prakriti, is equal to Apara, is equal to Vishaya, is equal to Drushyam, is equal to Anatma, is equal to Jadam. All these things are one and the same. So when we come across these words in several places, we have to immediately identify what it is. Then Kshetrajna, it is the intelligence principle, isn't it? Kshetrajna is equal to Purusha as against Prakriti. Then Purusha is equal to Para as against that Apara. And then Para, after that, it is Vishayi. Druk, it is Druk. Then later, it is Vishayi. Then it is the same as Atma, as against Anatma. Then it is Chetanam, as against Jadam. That is sentient, as against the insentient. So, this is how we have to understand this whole words. And then, in between, there is a shloka which says, this samsara, what is this samsara? This samsara is due to itaretara adhyasa, kshetra kshetragnayo sanyogaha. So, that is somewhere then 24th shloka, kshetra kshetragna sanyogaha. So, this kshetra kshetragna sanyoga, samyoga means, not exactly mixing up, itaretara adhyasa, that is superimposition of qualities of characteristics of one on the other, is that sanyoga, not literal sanyoga, but mere superimposition. So this superimposition is the cause for this samsara. So that is how this whole thing is structured. And I think we will go to the text. There is a small avatarika for the first shloka. Let us read the avatarika.
सप्तमे अध्याये
सूचिते द्वे प्रकृति ईश्वरस्य त्रिगुणात्मिका अष्टधा भिन्ना अपरा संसार हेतुत्वात्
पराच अन्या
जीवभूता
क्षेत्रज्ञलक्षणा
ईश्वरात्मिका याभ्यां प्रकृतिभ्यां ईश्वरः जगदुत्पत्तिस्थितिलयहेतुत्वं प्रतिपद्यते Okay. So here we are referring to the 7th chapter, Saptame Adhyaye, Suchite, Dve Prakruti Ishvarasya. So we saw the two Prakrutis, that is what is called Para Prakruti and Apara Prakruti. Para is sentient, Apara is insentient. Para relates to Kshetrajna, Apara relates to Kshetra. So there, Para again means Sat Chit Ananda Lakshanaha. Then here, this thing is Maya Lakshanaha. One is Sachidananda Lakshanaha, one is Maya Lakshanaha. So these two Prakrutis of Ishvara. Ishvara, we are not talking about this Maya Vachana Chaitanyam, we are talking about the Supreme Brahman. So there are two Prakrutis which are told here. Sachidananda Lakshana, when we say Sachidananda, you are referring to Brahma and not to Ishvara. Then Trigunatmika Ashtadha Bhinna. So Trigunatmika, these things we need not again explain. That is Sattva, Rajas, Tamoguna, how these things they are the constituents of that Maya. Then Ashtadha Bhinna. Ashtadha means eightfold, in eight ways. Ashta, Ashtadha, Navadha, Shatadha, Panchadha. So when this dha pratyaya means so many times it indicates ashtadha bhinna, so many times it looks divided. What are that? We saw that shloka, bhumi rapo vanalo vayuhu kammano buddhirevacha अहंकार इति यम मे भिन्ना प्रकृति रष्टधा इजंट इट वेर इज दिस ज्ञान विज्ञान योग भूमिरापो वनलो वायु खम मनो बुद्धिरेव च अहंकार इति यम मे भिन्ना प्रकृति रष्टधा सो भूमि दट इज ऑल दिस फाइव से भूतास फाइव एलिमेंट्स अर्थ वाटर फायर एयर एंड स्पेस देन खम ऑफ कोर्स स्पेस मन बुद्धि mind and intellect, then ahankara, this concept, this I, this notion I, that is what is ahankara, iti yamme bhinna prakruti rashtadha. When we talk about kshetrajna, in that kshetrajna, who is the person initially who thinks that he is the owner of that? It is the ahankara. At the ahankara level only, the person thinks I am this body-mind complex, but he is not the knower of the kshetra. He is only operating the kshetra, he is not the knower. The real knower, or in the real sense, the knower is the kshetrajna who will be able to distance himself. So anyway, here coming back to this, ashtadha bhinna is this eightfold nature. That is why Shiva is also called ashtamurtihi. So all these things are, say, figurative or metaphorical. So ashtadha bhinna, then apara samsara hetutvat. All these things are the karanam for this samsara, samsara hetutva. Then para cha anya jiva bhuta. Para is the superior, the higher level of reality, the higher level of reality. That is the jiva bhuta, that is the sentient principle. Jiva bhuta means that which is characterized as, that which is known as jiva or the sentient. Then kshetrajna lakshana. Ishwaratmika. So in the very first sentence, Shankaracharya has given an equation. Para is the same as jiva. If you see the sentence, the very first sentence means para is the same as jiva, is the same as kshetrajna. It is also Ishwaratmika, means of the nature of pure consciousness. You are thinking that you are some body-mind complex. You are of the nature of pure consciousness. So the very first sentence, if you note down, it means para is the same as jiva, it is equal to kshetrajna, it is equal to ishvara. The very first sentence he is saying like that. Then yabhyam prakrutibhyam ishvaraha, with these prakrutis, with these two prakrutis, because of the manifestation of these two prakrutis, it is not as though they are really there. Yabhyam because of these two manifestations, ishvaraha jagat utpatti sthiti laya hetutvam pratipadyate. So he is called Ishvara, he is called the creator, he is called the sustainer, he is called the person in charge of dissolution. All these cosmic functions we are attributing to Ishvara only because of the manifestation of these two prakrutis. So yabhyam prakrutibhyam, that is by virtue of these two prakrutis, Ishvaraha jagad utpatti hetu, sthiti hetu, laya hetu. That is, he is the cause for this utpatti, that is creation. He is the cause for sustenance. He is the cause for dissolution. So that is how he is getting those names. Hetutvam pratipadyate. He is attaining. Pratipadyate means he attains. Pratipadyate means he attains that particular status as the creator, as the sustainer, as the dissolver. By virtue of these two prakrutis which manifest in him. Then tatra kshetra kshetrajna lakshana prakruti dvaya nirupana dvarena tadvatah ishvarasya tatva nirdharanartham kshetradhyayah arabhyate. So here tatra, so in that context, kshetra kshetrajna lakshana prakruti dvaya nirupana. So this prakruti dvayam, which is called apara prakruti and para prakruti, which is the same as kshetra kshetrajna lakshana. In other words, you can call it kshetra kshetrajna. Apara prakruti is kshetram, para prakruti is kshetrajna. So tadvataha ishvarasya. Tadvataha means ishvara who is tadvan. He is the owner, he is the man under whose control they are there. So he is the boss of both of them, tadvan, dhanavan, gunavan, something similar. Tadvan means kshetradvayavan, tat means kshetradvayam, isn't it? Not kshetradvaya, prakruti dvaya. That prakruti dvayavan, दि षष्ठी तत्पुरुष षष्ठी विभक्ति फॉर तद्वान इज तद्वतः तद्वतः पर ईश्वरस्य द टू दट ईश्वर हू ईज द बॉस ऑफ दीज टू हू ईज द कंट्रोलर ऑफ दीज टू इन हूम दीज टू आर मैनिफेस्टिंग फॉर दैट तत्व निर्धारणार्थम हूज तत्व निर्धारण ईश्वर से तत्व निर्धारण इन ऑर्डर टू अटेन असटेन द रियल नेचर ऑफ दैट इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड द रियल नेचर ऑफ ईश्वर दिस पर्टिकुलर अध्याय ईज बीइंग कमेंस्ड आरभ्यते इट ईज बीइंग कमेंस्ड इज इट क्लियर सो फार बिकॉज लैंग्वेज हियर समटाइम्स एज वी गो इन टू द सेकेंड श्लोक द लैंग्वेज बिकम स्लाइटली मोर कॉम्प्लिकेटेड वी हैव टू बी केयरफुली स्लोली एंड केयरफुली रीड दैट देन अतीतानंतराध्याये च अतीत अनंतराध्याये अद्वेष्टा सर्वभूतानां इत्यादिना यावद् अध्याय परिसमाप्तिः तावत् तत्वज्ञानिनां सन्यासिनां निष्ठा यथा यथा ते वर्तन्ते इत्येतदुक्तम् केन पुनः ते तत्वज्ञानेन युक्ताः यथोक्तधर्माचरणात् भगवतः प्रिया भवन्ति इत्येवमर्थश्च अयम् अध्यायः आरभ्यते सो ही इज टेलिंग दि पर्पस् फॉर विच दिस अध्याय इज बीइंग कमेंस्ड द पर्पस् फॉर विच दिस चैप्टर इज बीइंग कमेंस्ड वॉट इज दैट इन दट इन दि इमीडियटली प्रिसीडिंग चैप्टर अतीत अनंतर Atita means past. Anantara means immediately behind. Anantara, not much, no gap. Atita Anantara Adhyaya means immediately preceding chapter. That is the 12th chapter. There we saw this Jnani Lakshana, the characteristics of a Jnani. Adveshta, Sarvabhutana, Maitra, Karuna, Yevaja, Nirmamo, Nirahankara, etc., etc. We read all those things. So, Adveshta, Sarvabhutana, Mityadina, starting with that, यावद् अध्याय परिसमाप्तिः टिल द एंड ऑफ दैट चैप्टर टिल द एंड ऑफ दैट चैप्टर तत्वज्ञानिनां सन्यासिनां निष्ठा सो हाउ ए तत्वज्ञानी स्टेज व्हाट इज हिज निष्ठा व्हाट इज हिज से फ्रेम ऑफ माइंड ऑल दैट हैज बीन डिस्क्राइब्ड यथा ते वर्तन्ते हाउ दे फंक्शन हाउ दे बिहेव इन द वर्ल्ड सो ऑल दैट थिंग हैज बीन टोल्ड देन केन तत्वज्ञानेन युक्ताः प्रिया भवन्ति So, what type of tatvajnanam is that? So, that has to be explained. What type of tatvajnanam is giving that, say, all those characteristics? Adveshta sarvabhutanam, they can be cultivated by the seeker also. But then he is not, he has not attained that, say, jnanam. So, a jnani, jnanam gives rise to certain characteristics or personality traits, let us say. And those personality traits are consciously cultivated by the seeker also. So that automatically does not give him jnanam. Seeker, he has to cultivate these things and simultaneously he should be doing shravana manana nididhyasa. That should not be forgotten because all through Bhakti Yoga, Shankaracharya was repeatedly pointing out whenever that Bhakti was mentioned, along with that Bhakti, you have to have this shravana manana nididhyasana. Simply because you consciously cultivate the habit of Adveshta, Maitraha, Karunaha, etc., you will not become a Jnani. You will definitely become a better human being, but certainly not this Brahmavid Brahmaiva Bhavati level. So for this, you have to have this Shravana Manana Nididhyasana. So this Shravana Manana Nididhyasana, they give a particular, type of personality. They give, in modern words, it gives rise to or it leads to a particular type of personality. So that particular personality was described in that 12th chapter. So how that personality has come into effect? What is that philosophy which has given rise to that personality? Okay, this is a better way. What is that philosophy and what is that understanding which has given rise to that personality? That has to be understood. So in order to explain that, this particular chapter is being commenced. Is it clear? केन पुनः तत्वज्ञानेन युक्ताः बै विच फिलॉसफी इम्ब्यूड बै विच फिलॉसफी लेट अस से इम्ब्यूड बै विच फिलॉसफी So all those people, yathokta dharmacharanat bhagavatah priya bhavanti, all that ethical say principles which were described in say this chapter 12, they become natural characteristics of a jnani. So this philosophy is giving rise to a particular character, a personality say type, isn't it? So what is this philosophy? That has to be understood. What is that tattvajnanam? What is that tattvajnanam means the nature of what is the supreme. The nature of what you are and what is the supreme, so that has to be understood. So for that, this adhyaya arabhyate. Then prakrutischa trigunatmika sarva karya karana vishayakarena parinata purushasya bhoga apavargartha kartavyataya देहेन्द्रियाद्याकारेण संहन्यते यो सोयं संघाता इदं शरीरं तदेतद् भगवान् उवाच. सो ही इज टेलिंग अबाउट द प्रकृति. सो जस्ट नाउ आई वाज सेइंग द ह्यूमन बॉडी अलोन इज नॉट द क्षेत्रम, द माइक्रोकॉस्म इज द सेम एज मैक्रोकॉस्म. So that is what he is saying. Prakrutischa trigunatmika. This prakriti which is having these three constituents, this sattva, rajas, tamoguna, and from this sarva karya karana vishaya karena parinata. So prakriti is the thing which is undergoing this parinama. We know the word parinama. Parinama means a change, something like a chemical change. The milk becoming curd is a parinama. The rope appearing as a snake is not parinama. It is called vivarta. So Brahma Parinama, we should not say it is Brahma Vivarta. Prakruti Parinama, Prakruti Parinamate, Brahma Vivartate. So that is the point. So here we are talking about Parinama. So that is why he says Parinata, Prakruti hi Parinata, means Parinamam Upagata, that is Parinata, Parinamam Prapta, let us say. So prakrutischa trigunatmika sarva karya karana vishaya karena, in the shape of all these karya karana sanghata, karya is body, karana is senses, all the sense organs, that is all the sense organs are called karana. Karana means a tool, an instrument. An instrument for what? An instrument for perception. All these instruments for understanding. So all these instruments for knowing, for cognizing things. So sarva karyakarana vishayakarena parina, and also vishayakarena, karyakarana vishaya, and also objects. Vishaya is the thing which is known by these karanas. So that is it. Karyakarana vishayakarena parinata. Then how, why is it so? Purushasya bhoga apavargartha kartavyataya. So purushasya, the whole creation is said to be because of the say the karma of the human beings. And then purushasya bhogapavargartha, it is the human body is the vehicle, both for bhoga, that is enjoyment, and also for apavarga. Enjoyment means not only enjoying, not happiness, including unhappiness also. Bhoga, bhujyate iti bhogaha, bhoga does not necessarily mean enjoyment, that is experiencing both good and bad, that is what is called bhoga. So bhogayatanam shariram, the karma, what is this, the logicians, they define the human body, tarka sangraha, if you read, bhogayatanam shariram, there is a definition for shariram, that is bhogasya ayatanam, that is, this is the place for experiencing the good or bad. So bhoga, for experiencing good or bad, again depending on whatever is your karma. So bhoga, and also apavarga. It is also the tool, it is also the instrument in order to attain moksha. Apavarga is moksha, isn't it? Swarga, apavarga, you must have heard about these two words. Swarga is heaven, apavarga is, it is the moksha. So purushasya bhoga apavarga, bhoga apavarga, bhoga apavarga artha kartavyataya. It is for bhoga and it is also karma bhumi. We know this word karma bhumi. Karma bhumi is, this is the place where you do all your endeavors in order to raise yourself from this level to a higher level. So that is what is karma bhumi. This endeavor for moksha in this birth only and not in a animal birth or in some other divine birth. So this is the place for karma. This is the karma bhumi. So bhogapavargartha kartavyataya. Kartavyata means it has to be done, it has to be performed. That is, it has to bhoga also is a kartavyata here, apavarga also is a kartavyata here. So for that, dehendriya dhyakarena samhanyate. So samhanyate means it gets formed into a sort of conglomerate. It gets formed into a sort of assemblage. Let us say sanghata. Sanghata is an assemblage, isn't it? Samhanyate is it becomes an assemblage is samhanyate. Samhanga sanghata. You have come across this word in Keno Upanishad also, karyakarana sanghata, samhanyate. So this deha indriya dhyakarena. So in the shape of this human body, the human body is from the tamasa aspect of the panchabhutas. Indriyas are from the sattvic aspect of the panchabhutas. So like that. So dehendriya dhyakarena parinamate. So it undergoes change in that particular fashion. Samhanyate soyam sanghatah. That sangha, thus this particular sanghata, saha ayam becomes soyam. That this means that thing which has transformed into this. That is that prakriti which has transformed into this. So that is what is called soyam, saha ayam, that this. Soyam sanghatah. Idam shariram, this particular body, this particular say human body, or not only human body, any body, starting from an ant. We talk about ant also. So idam shariram, tad etad bhagavan vacha. Tad, Bhagavan is now telling about that body. So let us read this shloka, the first shloka. Idam shariram kaunteya,
idam shariram kaunteya,
kshetramityabhidhiyate,
kshetramityabhidhiyate,
etadyo vetti tam prahuh,
etadyo vetti tam prahuh,
kshetrajna iti tadvidah,
kshetrajna iti tadvidah.
So let us see the shloka. Initially we should have said Shri Bhagavan Vacha. Okay, Shri Bhagavan Vacha, idam shariram kaunteya kshetramityabhidhiyate etadyo vetti tam prahu kshetrajnyaiti tadvidah. Okay, then idam shariram, see the shloka. This body, idam, when you say this means it is something which is objectifiable. You can note down also, idam is something which means it is something which is nameable, which is objectifiable, which is separable from you. Idam shariram. Shariram, the meanings, of course, they are, let me see whether they are given in the Bhashyam. Yeah, shariram, yes, some are given. Shariram, we know the meaning of shariram. Shiryate iti shariraha. Shiryate, that is something which disintegrates. Shiryate. Shirigipodam, what we call in Telugu shiri, that is shiriyate, shiri, that is it gets torn apart. So it disintegrates, it gets torn apart. That is what is sharira, shiriyate. That this shariram, he Kaunteya, O son of Kunti, O Arjuna, kshetram iti abhidhiyate. Kshetram, we explained the word kshetra, field. Metaphorically, it is something which produces some, it gives an yield to you depending on what you sow in that. Then iti, kshetram iti, iti means like that, in that manner, abhidhiyate, it is told or it is called, it is named. You know the word abhidhanam. Abhidhanam is name. Abhidhiyate means it is named so. Abhidhanam is name. Krishna abhidhanaha, Rama abhidhanaha, I am called, saha Rama abhidhanaha, so he is named or he is called Rama. Sah Krishna Abhidhanah, so he is named Krishna, so like that, Abhidhanam is name. Then Abhidhiyate, Yetad Yo Vetti, this particular Kshetram, Yaha Vetti, the one who knows, Yaha Yetad Vetti, the one who knows this, who realizes its real nature. Vetti means not as a body, I am so and so, I am having such a handsome body, I am so and so, my muscles are so great, not like that. the reality of this body, body-mind complex, one who understands the reality of this body-mind complex, he is called Tam Prahuhu Kshetrajnyaiti Tadvidaha. Tadvidaha means the people who know that, the wise men. Kshetrajnyaiti Tam Prahuhu. They call him as Kshetrajnya. They call him Kshetrajnya. They call whom? एतद्यो वेत्ति तम द वन हू नोस दिस ही इज कॉल्ड क्षेत्रज्ञ बै द वाइज मैन सो दट इज द सेकंड लाइन सो लेट अस सी दि भाष्यम फॉर इट दि श्लोक इज सिंपल बट भाष्यम वी हैव टू सी क्लोजली इदमिति सर्वनाम्ना उक्तम विशिनष्टि उत्तम विशिनष्टि शरीरमिति शरीरमिति ओके हे कौंतेय क्षतत्राणात् क्षयात् क्षरणात् क्षेत्रवद् क्षेत्रवद्वा अस्मिन् कर्मफल निर्वृत्तेः क्षेत्रमिति इति शब्दः एवं शब्दपदार्थकः ओके शरीरमिति इदमिति सर्वनाम्ना उक्तम् इदम् इदम् इस् ए सर्वनाम सर्वनाम मीन्स् प्रोनौन् वाट् इस् अ प्रोनौन् प्रोनौन् इस् समथिङ्ग् विच् केन् बि अप्लिकबल् टु एनिथिङ्ग् यू केन् काल् दिस् पेन् एस् दिस् यू केन् काल् ए बुक् एस् दिस् यू केन् काल् दट् स्टोन् एस् दिस् यू केन् काल् ए ट्री एस् दिस् 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 एनिथिङ्ग् विच् इस् सीन् एनिथिङ्ग् विच् इस् सीन् ईस् दट् दिस् इट् ईस् समथिङ्ग् विच् इस् एन् आब्जेक्टिफैबल् थिङ्ग् सो दट् ईस् वाट् इस् दिस् दिस् पर्टिक्युलर् थिङ्ग् विच् ईस् टोल्ड् इन् दिस् प्रोनौन् प्रोनौन् इदम् इस् अ प्रोनौन् इसन्ट् इट् this by that that is being explained visinashti means that he is that he is explaining he explains he elaborates then what is that kshata tranat kshata kshata means something some hurt from hurt something this is something which is kshata tranat there is a small explanation given by वन् कामेण्टेटर् रामराय कवि क्षतत्रायते इति ओके क्षतत्राणात् दट् ईस् इन् वाट् मेनर् ईस् दिस् बाडि मैण्ड् काम्प्लेक्स् इञ्जर्ड् आर् हर्ट् दट् ईस् बिकास् आफ् इग्नोरेन्स् देन् बिकास् आफ् इग्नोरेन्स् वी डू सम् बेड् डीड्स् एण्ड् देन् बिकास् आफ् दीस् बेड् डीड्स् ए पर्सन् गोस् टु हेल् आर् ही सफर्स् सम् अदर् बेड् कान्सिक्वेन्सस् सो फ्रम् आल् दोस् थिङ्ग्स् इट् ईस् ए टूल् टु प्रोटेक्ट् somebody so it is a tool to go down it is a tool to go up also so shariram also this whole the body mind complex is something which is there either to go down or to go up so that commentator writes gnanotpadana dwara narakaadi lakshanat kshatat trayate so he says so it enables you to achieve gnana it enables you to realize yourself and then from that narakaadi lakshanat kshatat from the great damage kshata means damage hurt great damage called naraka it trayate it protects so that is why it is called kshetram kshatat kshata tranat so that is number 1 kshatat tranat that is one explanation then kshayat trayate kshayat means kshayat kshetram that is because it declines it goes on disintegrating it goes on perishing so it is that it is the nature it is of perishing nature so that is why it is called kshetram then kshayat kshranat kshranam kshrana is another root so this he is giving various derivations for this word kshetram so kshranat kshranam means something which leaks down kshrana literally means something which leaks down something which disintegrates something which becomes weak feeble so that is the meaning so something which disintegrates then kshetravadva अस्मिन् कर्मफल निर्वृत्तेः क्षेत्रमिति सो मेटफारिकली स्पीकिङ्ग् क्षेत्रवत् सो लैक् ए फील्ड् अस्मिन् मीन्स् अस्मिन् देहे आर् अस्मिन् शरीरे इन् दिस् बाडि कर्मफल निर्वृत्ति निर्वृत्ति मीन्स् यु आर् हार्वेस्टिङ्ग् आल्मोस्ट् निर्वृत्ति डस् नाट् मीन् हार्वेस्ट् फर् द होल् वर्ल्ड् ऐ एम् टेलिङ्ग् कर्मफल निर्वृत्ति Nirvruti is, the whole karma phala, it materializes here. The karma phala, it takes shape here, Nirvruti. Karma phala takes shape here, karma phala materializes here, karma phala is harvested here. So for that reason, it is metaphorically called kshetram. Is it okay? Metaphorically, karma, kshetravat, asmin, in this body, karma phalasya nirvruti. Nirvruti means actually nirvartanam. You know the word nirvartanam? Something which is materializing. So karma phala materializes here, karma phala takes shape here, karma phala is harvested here. Harvest again is something metaphorical which I use. So for this karma phala, it can be sukha, dukha, all these things, roga, arogya, it can be any type of karma phala. All these things is, it materializes here. Then, iti shabdaha evam padartha, shabda padarthaka. Iti means evam, in this manner it is told. Iti means ityevam uchyate, ityevam abhidhiyate. The meaning of iti is ityevam, that is, in this manner it is told, it is called, it is designated. Then,
Kshetram ityevam
abhidhiyate, kathyate. Your book has something else or what? Abhidhiyate.
Kshetram ityevam
kathyate. Okay, abhidhiyate, kathyate. So, Kshetram ityevam, iti means evam, in this manner it is told, it is named like that. Then,
etat shariram,
kshetram yo vetti vijanati, apada talamastakam jnanena vishayikaroti, swabhavikena aupadeshikena va
vedanena
vishayikaroti
vibhagashah
tam veditaram prahuhu kathayanti kshetrajna iti. Okay, this particular body, etat shariram, this particular shariram. Shariram we have now understood that is something which is of the nature of, which is of perishing nature. Then kshetram again, kshetram is something which enables you to do some good job, enables you to do some bad job, that is one derivation. And also it perishes, that is one derivation. Then again it disintegrates, that is another derivation. Then again it is something like a kshetram where you can do some good deed and get a good result. So that is another derivation. So four derivations Shankaracharya has given. So like in that manner, yo vetti, somebody who understands. Then what is the meaning of understands? Vetti, vijanati, knows quite well. In what manner? Apada talamastakam jnanena vishayikaroti. Jnanena vishayikaroti means it is an object for his jnanam. The whole body mind complex becomes an object for this jnanam. So the body mind complex, of course, it is very difficult to distinguish. As I said, jnanam is so closely mixed up with the body mind complex that it sees itself as the karta, it sees itself as the body, it sees itself as the prana. Body means something like a vastu, an object. Prana is the energy, that is kriya. Then karta. So the jnanam sees itself as a vastu, it sees itself as a kriya, it sees itself as a karta. So that is unfortunate predicament. So this jnana has to separate itself from this body mind complex. So apada talamastakam, not as though this is my leg, this is my hand, not this is my finger, not like that. So you have to distance yourself from this whole body at all, totally. Vishayi karoti, then swabhavikena aupadeshikena va vedanena, either naturally or aupadeshikena. Aupadeshika means upadesha, because of upadesha. Something belonging to upadesha, something depending on upadesha is aupadeshikam. Or by upadesha means something by proper shravana manana nididhyasana, proper adhyaya of the scriptures. Vishayi karoti, then vibhagashah means By properly distinguishing. Vibhaga we know. Vibhaga is to distinguish. Vibhagashaha is, what type of vibhaga is this? Atma anatma viveka. Viveka actually means, as I said, viveka, it is from the root vichir, prutak bhave, something which separate, to distinguish chaff from the grain. So vibhagashaha, then atma anatma, vivekashaha. Tam veditaram prahuhu kathayanti. Prahuhu means kathayanti. People say kshetrajna iti. Then iti shabdaha.
Vedana
is knowledge. Vedana does not mean suffering. Vedana vid dhatu. Vid dhatu means, vid means to know. The same root from which the word Veda also comes. Vid, Vedana. Vedana is knowledge, experience. So that is depending again on the context. Sometimes it can mean experience. विद लिटरली मीन्स नॉलेज वेदनेन बै नोइंग औपदेशिकेन वा वेदनेन वेदना नॉट तेलुगु वी यूज इट रॉन्गली वेदना मीन्स सफरिंग आवेदना एंग्विश सो इट इज नॉट दैट सो समहाउ इन तेलुगु वी यूज सम ऑफ दी संस्कृत रूट्स इन ए टोटली डिफरेंट वे somehow it has come into practice like that क्षेत्रज्ञ इति इति शब्दः
इति शब्दः
एवं शब्द पदार्थक एव
एवं शब्द पदार्थकः एव
पूर्ववत् क्षेत्रज्ञ इत्येवम् आहुः
पूर्ववत् क्षेत्रज्ञ इत्येवम् आहुः
इति शब्दः एवं शब्द पदार्थकः सो वी हैव सीन दिस अर्लियर दैट इज इति मीन्स एवं टाइम इज ओवर ओके दिस सेंटेंस वी विल फिनिश ऑफ एवं शब्द पदार्थकः एव पूर्ववत् क्षेत्रज्ञ इत्येवम् आहुः सो लाइक एज अर्लियर क्षेत्रज्ञ इत्येवम् आहुः दिस अगेन द सेकेंड लाइन आल्सो एतद्योवेति तं प्राहुः क्षेत्रज्ञ इति सो द फर्स्ट लाइन आल्सो देर इज वन इति सेकेंड लाइन आल्सो द सेकेंड लाइन इति द मीनिंग फॉर बोथ इज सेम सो दट इज वाट ही सेज मीनिंग एट बोथ प्लेसेस इज इति एवम् अनि इन तेलुगु वी से अनि लाइक दिस इन दिस मैनर इट इज कॉल्ड सो हू हू काल दे हू हू सेसो तद्विदः तौ क्षेत्र क्षेत्रज्ञौ ये विदन्ति तद्विदः द पीपल हू नो दिस क्षेत्र एंड क्षेत्रज्ञ दे काल दिस पीपल दे काल दिस जेंटलमैन एज क्षेत्रज्ञ द पर्सन हू इज एबल टू डिस्टिंग्विश आत्मा फ्रॉम अनात्मा ईज कॉल्ड क्षेत्रज्ञ बै वाइज मेन सो दट इज वॉट इट ईज लेट अस कंटिन्यू इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास ओम पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेव अवशिष्यते ओम शांति शांति शांति।